grammar tonight. Good day, class. This morning, we want to look at angles. Angles. If you say angles, angles are measured using an instrument called protractor. Angles are measured using an instrument called protractor. Remember when we started construction, I introduced some instrument to you in which we use for construction. So if we want to construct angle, we use two major instruments. These are the ruler and the protractor. Ruler and protractor. This is the protractor. And you see, remember we used this last week. This is the protractor. And this protractor is looks like a semicircle. And the protractor is marked in degrees from 0 to 180 degrees. If you look at it, if you check your mathematical set, open your mathematical set, you can see the protractor. It is being marked from 0 to 180 or from 0 here to 180. It's either you count from here to this side or you count from here to this side. Now, let's look at some angles. Some angles, the first one is acute angle. Acute angle. An acute angle is an angle less than 90 degrees. So angle that range from 0 to 89.9999 is an acute angle. Any angle less than 90 degrees is an acute angle. E.g. 5 degrees, 10 degrees, 50 degrees, 60 degrees is an example. Just was an example of an acute angle. Now the other word is Ortiz angle. An Ortiz angle is an angle greater than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees. Any angle that range from 90.1 to 180 is called an acute, an Ortiz angle rather. So if for example, you have 91 degrees, you have 150 degrees, you have 179 degrees, all along like that, they are called them Ortiz angle. Now, the next one is right angle. Right angle. A right angle is an angle equal to 180, is equal to 90 degrees. A right angle is an angle equal to 90 degrees. The next one is reflex angle. A reflex angle is an angle greater than 180 degrees but less than 360 degrees. Angle greater than 180 degrees but less than 360 degrees. For example, we have 200 degrees is an reflex angle, 350 degrees is a reflex angle, all along like that. So, we have an example here. The diagram has been drawn and we are asked to measure the angle for each of these diagrams. Remember I said you are going to use protractor. You are going to use protractor to do what? To take the measurement. So we are going to measure from here to here. We are going to know the value from here to here and also the last one here. Now let's start. If you want to measure, you first of all place your protractor on. And I told you, if you look at a protractor, you can see there is a black line that is referring, that is pointing at the center of that protractor. So you are going to place that your what? Your the middle of your protractor, you place it like this. I hope you are following me. You place it like this. In the sense that this, the base of this protractor will be in line with the base of this angle. Can you see? So you now do what? You now trace. You start counting from the base here to here because you can see the arrow, how it moves. Then let's count. This is 0. From here to here is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Here I have 50. That means this angle is angle 50 degrees. Angle 50 degrees. And this angle is an example of an acute angle because it is less than 90 degrees. The other one here, same thing, you place the middle of your protractor on the edge of the base of this line. Can you see? You now do what? Then you count. From here to here is 10, 20, 30, 40. As I'm counting here, this one is 46. I can count 46. So it's telling us that from here to here is 46 degrees. This also is an example of an acute angle. Example of an acute angle. The last one here, if you look at this last one, it's a little bit different from the first two. What do you have to do for you not to disturb yourself, or shall I say it? The first thing you have to do, total number, the total degree of an angle is 360 degrees. Angle at a point is 360 degrees. But we are asked to find the measurements from here to here, Abby. The first thing we have to do is for it to be very easy. We take the measurements of the remaining one here, then you subtract it from 360 degrees. Your final answer will be from here to here. Why? Because it's not easy for you to start turning your protractor, because it's not a complete circle. As if it's a complete circle, you can start turning. But since it's not a complete circle, it's not easy for us to be turning. What you have to do, just place the middle of your protractor here. Place it on the edge of that line, and you measure this 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. From here to here is 50. From here to here is 50 degrees. Why is this what you are looking for and not this one? But since we got this place from here to here to be 50 degrees, we just do what? We subtract 50 degrees from 50 degrees from 360 degrees. What do you have left? 310 degrees. Therefore, from here to here is 310 degrees. If you have 310 with 50, it will give us 360 degrees, which is angle at a point. Now, let's construct this one. Is by the way, let's construct an angle using protractor. Now, you know this one, we have been given the angle, they said we should measure. But this time around, we want to use protractor to construct. The first one thing, the first angle I want to construct here is angle 82 degrees. Angle 82 degrees. Construct angle 82 degrees. How to construct angle 82 degrees? How do I start? The first step is to do what? To draw a line of any length. You know, we did something of this nature last week. Line of any what? Of any length. Can you see? That's my own straight line. Then name it with any letter you want except letter O. So I want to name mine as letter X and letter Y. So this is line X, Y. The second step you have to do is to take your protractor. The second step, you take your protractor. This is the middle of my line X. Can you see? Then you take your protractor and you measure 82 degrees. I want to measure 82 degrees. How do I start? You are going to do this, how you are going to place your protractor. You now have marked here my X. You now place the middle of your protractor on that line X. Then you measure your 82 degrees. This is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. 81, 82. This is my 82 degree. This is my 82 degree. I can just say. This is my 82 degree. This is just a sign. This is my 82 degree. Then after that, I just use this line to show you. Let me redraw. How to redraw? This is my X. This is my Y. This is my 82 degree here. 80, 81, 82. This is my 82 degree. Then you do what? You now join the line. Join the line. So this means from here to here is 82 degree. Look at this line. It's a little bit flat. Telling you that it remains just few numbers. Few figures for it to be complete, to be a complete right angle triangle. 82 minus 90 minus 82 is what? Is 8. Just make 8 inches for it to be what? To be on a straight line. This is the straight line, but this one is 82, that's why it looks like this. The reason why I draw this one, so that you can know that it starts counting from here to here. Are you with me? So this is my 82 degrees. So I can make this place as my Z. So from here to here is my 82 degree. Now let me construct another one. I hope you've written this in your notes. Let's construct another angle. Mind you, this 82 degree is an example of acute angle because it is less than 90 degrees. It is less than 90 degrees. Now let's construct a reflex angle. Let's construct a reflex angle. I remember a reflex angle is an angle greater than 180 degrees but less than 360 degrees. Greater than 180 degrees and less than 360 degrees. I want to construct angle 300 degrees. Angle 300 degrees. How do I construct that? To construct a reflex angle of 300 degrees, first of all, you have to calculate the remaining angle. Remember when we are doing the example, the third example here, we subtracted. So then you have to first of all subtract the related angle, which is 360 degrees minus 300 degrees. What do you have? 60 degrees. So is this 60 degrees that you are going to measure? And the remaining angle will be your 300 degree. Now let me do that. I have my straight line. That's my straight line. They also first of all construct this 60 degree, which is here. 60 is my 60. Is my 60 degree. So from here, let me name A, B, C. From here to here is 60 degree. Since from here to here is 60 degree, therefore the remaining angle here will be my 300 degree. It be my 300 degree. So this is how to construct a reflex angle. You first of all subtract the value from 360. Then you construct that related angle, which is the angle, the answer that you got here is called related angle. This 60 degree I got here is called related angle. You first of all construct this related angle. Then the remaining one, the remaining angle, the remaining size will be what you need. If you have 60 plus 300, it will give us 360 degrees. Now I'm going to give you an assignment in which you are going to construct some angles. Some are reflex, some are acute. So here's where we are going to stop for today. Here's where we are going to stop for today. You are going to see that assignment on your portal. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.